We are in over at UK Detailing at the moment, and we are doing one of the very final articles that we'll probably be putting in issue 8. As you can imagine, we've got about a week and a bit until we go to print, so we're putting very, very long hours at the moment, hence the slightly unshaven look, slightly homeless look at the moment. But we are shooting an article today on arch cleaning, and we have a very interesting car. I was going to say it's lovely, but I'm going to go with interesting. It is a DeLorean. So we're talking DMC12, stainless steel body, Renault V6.
I think iconic is the word you're looking for. Iconic car.
There we go. I've avoided prison once again. So what I wanted to do is just a very quick update video on what we're going to do. And Ian, our features editor and full-time detailer, is going to run through the processes we're going to do. So what I'm first of all going to do is just come and grab the camera. Apologies for the gut shot. And we're going to come and have a little look inside the arch. So what you can see at the moment is that the arch is pretty filthy dirty, to be honest. It's seen some miles. Condition-wise, it really ain't that bad. But Ian, do you want to start telling us what you're going to be doing?
Yeah, sure. I mean, obviously, the first step we normally take with something like this is, if it was outside, with the wheels on still, obviously, snow come under, then give it a quick blast out with a jet wash, just so any of the big clumps, etc., come out there. So we bring it inside, come up on the ramp, wheels off, and as you can look in here, gives us a chance to get a good bit of inspection there, which is ideal for doing this just before it goes away for winter. So already what I can see under here is you've got a split steering wheel gate, steering column gate here, just so we know, we put a bit of plastic around that just before we start cleaning, just so we don't wash out any of the oils, and we'll clean that individually a little bit later on. Looking up on the suspension here, you see all of this up here is just flaking away, just allowing surface rust to build up. So what we're going to do, just give this a quick brush back, get everything loose off of there, and we're going to treat it with some stone chip guard, some nice black stone chip guard. That'll inhibit the rust on there and give it a little bit of protection going forward. All of this under here, just covered in grease, so we're just going to give that a clean off with degreaser, see what's underneath it, see if we have to go anything a little bit more intensive. See it as well on here, this strut down here has got a little bit of rust on there as well, so we'll carry on with the stone chip guard on there. The point is just to be able to look under there, see if there's any problems, get it nice and clean before it goes away, so by the time you get it out you don't find that something's been sitting there over the winter and causing you issues.
Cool beans. So yeah, we're talking about everything there, from the strut slash anti-roll bar and the brakes and the suspension and all of those bits that can be cleaned up. Bear in mind, we're not doing too much in the way of mechanical work. This is purely kind of cosmetic surface stuff. But at the same time, it will allow us to discover any other gremlins that are underneath it. But actually, for an 81 car,
it's not bad. Not bad at all. How many miles this has got?
I did look. I think it was about 50-something.
Okay.
So not,
I just
not...
looked to check the clock went up to 88.
So, anyway, in terms of the equipment we're going to be using, we've got various brushes. So, again, down here, I'm trying to film this ourselves. It's not being filmed by Rich. It's just that we're all doing it very low down at the moment. We've got a Vicam brush by there, the looks of it. We've got a Valet Pro detailing brush. And various other bits and bobs.
I've just got a couple of old ones there as well, because obviously once you start brushing away with any little metal flakes on there, you can just throw this in the bin or just keep it for that going forward. You've also got a new one in there just for the plastics we need to get into any tight spaces. Obviously these little
wire ones. I'm guessing we don't use those on paint if we can avoid it.
No, but in theory you probably could put some nice graining back into the side of it with these. But no, again, nice soft bristles, just so they're just going to take off anything loose over there and give us a nice surface for the stone chip guard to go into. Then we've got more than sort of little wheel woolies, got larger wheel woolies in the bucket of warm water with some APC there, a slightly larger brush just for scrubbing away at the inner arch itself.
That's cool. And then product-wise, I can see you've got a purple bottle there, which I believe is a degreaser. It's a kind of detergent.
Yeah, detergent degreaser. It's quite a heavy-duty one. It's not the sort of thing you want to use on the paintwork, but it's going to really get rid of anything that's been ingrained into the plastic. Give it a good wash-off first.
That's cool. And then we've got some more products over here. So I'm just trying to do the camera. I'm not very good at talking to camera, but I'm even worse at photos and video. But anyway, here we go. We've got some HyperClean. What's that?
That's an engine degreaser. It's solvent-based. It's just going to do a very similar job to things like brake cleaner, but it's going to actually sit on the surface for a little bit longer, allow it to penetrate and get rid of a lot of the grease you'd find built up in an engine bay. obviously in something like this, we'll be using that around the struts and anywhere there's been any misting of oil coming in. Okay. Obviously not any oil down the front, but...
Yeah, well, of course, it's a kind of a rear mid-engine thing, yes. Isn't it? So hopefully...
Just like a Ferrari.
Just like a Ferrari in so few ways. Then we've got some Powermax Tar-Off, which is basically a solvent cleaner as well as a Tar-Off side,
yes.
Isn't it?
Yes, I've got that just to see if there are any tar spots under there, we can get rid of that, but mostly because what we're going to use next, which is the stone chip guard here, that's just going to be it's going to make it easier for us to take off any excess that comes over onto the sides when we're spraying that around.
Gotcha.
We've got the stone chip guard here itself.
And you've got that in hot water, why, or warm water, why is that?
Just makes it a lot easier to spray, a bit similar for when you're using aerosol spray paints. It just makes the product a lot easier, cleaner coming out, let's say.
Gotcha, and it has to be said, it's quite a chilly day, although you've got a rather good Samsung heater thing.
Yeah, or Mitsubishi, it's 19 degrees in here, so it's not too bad, it's
pretty
sort
toasty.
Of a late autumn.
And what's finally the blue stuff?
Bluey purple stuff on the end because you're colourblind.
Oh, yeah.
That's just a plastic dressing. We use that for engines and plastics, so it's going to go all around the wheel wells. It's solvent based wells, so it's not going to cover it well with silicons. It is going to get the last bit of any grease off of there and just give it a little bit of protection going forwards.
That's brilliant. Okie dokie. If we can, we are going to try and do some updates later on. But for now, I'll just let you admire this stainless steel icon and we will get to work and start shooting and all the rest of it. Hello. We have been hard at work for the last hour or so, just getting this wheel arch looking good on this lovely DeLorean. Now I say we, it's kind of more Ian, who's hiding in the corner here. Ian, what have you done to this car?
Well, as we were before, put some stone chip guard onto these wishbones and the anti-roll bar down here. All of that dirt up in the arches has come off and we've dressed up in there. There is some evidence of some black spray paint's been in here before. But we're not going to get that off with this sort of process. All the chassis, everything back here is nice and clean, all the aluminium, we've got all the gross out of there, all from down inside these little crevices. Not touching anything on the brake discs at the moment. You could at this point sort of take the rust off the edge of the disc here and sort of paint up the hub and everything, make it look nice and shiny and new and everything, but that's not what the owner wants for this, it's just keeping it nice and original.
Cool. Well, as I say, it's taken, how long do you reckon it's taken? About 45 minutes, an hour or so?
Yeah, probably about an hour altogether.
And none of the kit that we've used, bar perhaps quite a high-end steamer, is something that only a professional detailer would have. It's all available to the public. So if you're an enthusiast, maybe you don't have a DeLorean, maybe you have a reliable car, then it's something that you can do at home. And in issue 8, probably, we're going to, i.e. the one coming out this Christmas 18, we are going to put more detail here, all the products used, all the processes, and it really kind of be a handy step-by-step guide to get your arches looking that good. So you can get your subscription for 2018 at www.pro-detailer.com as part of the 2018 subscription. And as I say, it'll probably go into that issue. We might bump it to July, depending on what other content we have coming along. We are now only a week away from submitting it, hence we're all looking somewhat haggard and hairy because we've been pulling night duties as well as day duties, but we're not far off getting it sent off to printers. It then takes about 10 days, so we can expect to get it in Cirencester ready for dispatch to you guys circa 10th to 12th of December, so you'll certainly have it well in time for Christmas. And if there are some products you see in there as well, you'll be able to get those with any deals, because there are quite a few people offering deals in it that you can get in time for Christmas. Anyhow, that's enough from us. Thank you very much for watching.